Hey everybody, Bob here, and welcome back to another Making Stuff video. Today I'm going to finish a video that I literally started over 2 years ago. So let's head on over to the workbench and I'll show you all about it. So it's been 2 years and 3 months since I made the video where I put these two batteries head to head and did a Dewalt battery showdown. And if you haven't seen that video, I'll put a link to it right here and also in the description of this video. In that video, I put each one of these batteries on the same drill with a half inch spade bit, and I just started drilling holes until the battery went dead. And if you remember, in that video, the generic battery, which is this one, drilled 63 holes before the tool shut off. So then I let the tool cool down. I got another 2x4, which I can't find, but I did the same test with the Dewalt battery and I only got 62 holes instead of 63. Now at the end of that video, I said I was going to test these for longevity to see which one lasted longer, and I have got that answer. But don't fast forward to the end where you can see the numbers, see which one lasted longer than the other one, because there's more to this than just the numbers. There's a little twist in this to make this story a little interesting. So just a little recap here. This battery I got on Banggood, and it is a 3 amp hour battery, and I also used a Dewalt 3 amp hour battery for this test. So the way I kept track of the longevity is I would use each battery until the tool shut off, and I use these on the same drill. This whole test, I used the same drill. So I put the battery on the drill and it stayed on the drill until the drill stopped running. And then I would put the battery on the charger and then I would mark that charge, that number, which charge it was, on a chart. And I did that for both batteries. I've got battery number one and battery number two. So I've been doing this for 2 years, or over 2 years, 2 years and 3 months. I finally got the answer, and both of these batteries have pretty much failed the exact same way. And that is that when you put it on the charger, it will only charge to 2 bars, and it has lost probably 25 to 30, maybe even 40% of its capacity. So it lasts about a little less than half, or a little more than half of what it did when it was brand new. This battery is the same way. When it's fully charged and it comes off the charger, it's only charged to 2 bars and it has lost 30 to 40% of its capacity. So both of these batteries have shown the beginning of failure exactly the same way. So these batteries they're on the downhill. They're on their way out. So now the answer, or the question, is which one lasted longer? Well, I'll tell you, the Dewalt 3 amp hour name brand battery, it lasted 23 charges, which kind of shocked me. I thought it would last longer, and that's a complete charge and discharge on the same drill. How many did the generic one last? This one lasted 28 charges. So I got 5 more charges out of the generic one than I did the name brand Dewalt. But the story's not over right there. The Dewalt battery has a 3-year warranty. The generic one does not have a warranty at all. In fact, I got this on Banggood. They don't even make this battery anymore. So here it is 3 years later. They don't make this one. Dewalt certainly still makes this one, and it has a 3-year warranty. I said it's 3 years later. It's actually a little less than 2.5 years later. So what I did, since this has a 3-year warranty on it, I contacted Dewalt and did a warranty replacement, and I did it over the computer through chat. It was very easy to do this. All I had to do was give them some information about when I bought the battery, and about 10 days later I had a new one in the mail. So I got a replacement on this one, no questions asked, from Dewalt. It was a very easy warranty return. This one, however, I'm just stuck with because, like I said, there's no warranty. They don't even make this battery any longer. So the question is, which one was the better value? This one got more charges, more use out of it than the name brand did, but I was able to get a replacement for this one because it has a 3-year warranty. So I would consider the Dewalt, even though it lasted 5 charges less, if my replacement that I got for this lasts 23 charges, just like this one did, then that means I got 46 charges for the same amount of money. Well, actually, it was a little bit more. I can't remember the prices because it's been a while. But all in all, got 46 charges from Dewalt, where I only got 28 out of the no name. So that's the end of this story that's been going on for 2 years. Both of these batteries, like I said, they're starting to fail. And these were also some of the first lithium batteries that I purchased out here in the shop, because at the time, most of my tools were still NiCad batteries. And so I don't know, maybe this is the way that these batteries fail. Maybe they just slowly lose capacity over time. And like I said, that's how they fail when they get old. To me, that's a little shocking because these batteries are less than 2.5 years old and they're already showing signs of failure. If that's the case, let me know. If you guys know, let me know in the comments. I like reading the comments from you guys. If you've had the same experience out of these batteries where the capacity just slowly dwindles over time and then the packs are no good, or do they fail in another way? Let me know down in the comments. But it kind of concerns me that these first lithium ion batteries that I bought are failing the same way, less than 2.5 years, because those NiCad battery packs, not only are they cheaper, but I could easily get 5 years out of a battery pack on those. And one other final note about these batteries is when I got the replacement for this, I asked Dewalt if I needed to send the old one back. They said no. They said just please recycle it. They said don't throw it away, please recycle it. And I'm not ready to get rid of these batteries just yet because I did find a use for them. I now call these my flashlight batteries. So I've got the Dewalt flashlight and it still works great for a flashlight battery because the drain from this flashlight is nothing near a power tool like what a drill or a saw or anything's going to draw out of it. And it will last a very long time still right now with a flashlight on it. So these are dedicated to my flashlights. I guess the day will eventually come where they won't even work with a flashlight. Then I will recycle them. But yeah, even though they are starting to fail and they don't last as long on the drill, they still have a use in my shop as a flashlight battery. So I hope you like this short little follow-up video. And if you've had similar results with your lithium ion batteries, let me know down in the comments. I still read all the comments and I'd love to hear from you guys. If you like the video, please give me that big thumbs up. And if you aren't a subscriber, please consider hitting that subscribe button so you don't miss any upcoming Making Stuff videos. And thanks for watching.